Tales of Toby, the Truck Dispatcher. Moving the Zoo. It was Tuesday, mid-morning, and Toby was having a cup of tea, biscuit, and a quiet read of the daily newspaper, The Chronicle. In big, bold letters, the headline stated, Zoo moving. As Toby read the story, he learnt that Tone Zoo was moving from its old, crowded location to an open, spacious site on the northeastern edge of towns. The zoo would have lots of spacious, modern enclosures for the small animals and open paddocks for the big animals to roam in. A special animal hospital was also included to look after the sick creatures, big and small. Toby was thinking, I will have to go and visit the new zoo. It sounds exciting and would be lovely to see all the animals roaming in their enclosures. Burr, 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 the white phone was ringing. Toby had to go back to work. Picking up his white phone, he said, Toby speaking, how may I help you? Dr. Janet Bones is my name, and I'm the town's zoo chief animal veterinarian. I was just reading about you, said Toby. Our moving is why I've called you. Dr. Janet Bones began to explain. Toby listened very carefully to what was required, and finally said to Dr. Janet Bones, we will be able to provide a crane and semi-trailer for at least a week. Dr. Janet Bones thanked Toby for everything and then hung up. Toby set about organizing his truck and crane for the next week. Layla, the low-end loader, and Sally, the slew crane, would be doing the work. Next Monday, at 9 a.m., Stefan driving Layla and Kenneth driving Sally arrived at the old zoo. There, they found Dr. Janet Bones, who outlined what they had to do each day. On arrival, each day, they would go to the loading dock, carefully load whichever large animal the zoo was moving on that day. After loading Layla, they were to drive to the new zoo and then unload the animals. Monday was the day to move the elephants. The crate the elephant was to use had bars, so the elephant could look out to see what was going on. Kenneth, in Sally, very carefully lifted the crate with the elephant in onto Layla. The crate was secured, and Stefan with a police escort drove off very carefully to the new zoo. With each trip, zoo staff would follow in cars in case of an emergency. The trip to the new zoo would normally take 30 minutes, but Stefan and Layla had to go slow as to not to scare the elephant. The trip took 2 hours. The convoy had to travel past the local shops, and some of the people came out to watch. The children were very excited to see the elephant. At the new zoo, Kenneth was already waiting for Sally, the slew crane, to unload. Kenneth did not have to drive very slow to get to the new zoo. That was the work they did, moving the big animals. Each day, a new animal would be moved. Tuesday were the lions, Wednesday the gorillas, Thursday the hippos. Friday was the hardest. Stefan and Kenneth had to move the giraffes. Not only did they stand so tall on the tray deck, but at every overhead wire crossing the road, an electrical crew had to be able to lift the wires so the giraffes did not touch them. This was a very slow trip to the new zoo. It was also the most unusual convoy for the people to see. Friday, the crowds along the route were huge, all waiting to see the giraffes being moved. At the school, everybody was out of class. People cheering and clapping. Everybody loved to see the giraffes with their heads so high in the air. With the giraffes in the zoo, the week's work was finished. Stefan and Kenneth were also very happy. They had moved all the big animals safely. At the back of each book, there are 10 questions, a poem, and a map. I will now read you the poem, The Zoo. From in the bush they came, where life was not the same, to live at the zoo. They live in shelters and are fed at night. They sleep in a warm bed. Life is good at the zoo. People come to look and see, to view the animals that were once free. That is a part of what zoos do. When animals are hurt and in pain, in the animal hospital they are retained, for the vets work hard with love to give their best to the zoo.